Hello, can you please introduce yourself first?
Okay, so I'm Keith Basu. I recently just graduated from my master's with physics at Presidency University, and that's all about me.
Okay, and can you please speak about your gender identity?
Yeah, of course. So I'm a transgender man, and that's what I say when someone asks what my gender identity is. Like, I feel like there are much more nuances to the gender identity, but I feel like the phrase transgender man describes it the best.
So I'm going to ask you some questions. These are like basic questions, and just be honest with it. We just want to know about your feelings.
Okay. Yeah, sure.
So, tell us a little about your journey of rediscovering oneself.
What exactly do you mean when you say rediscovering oneself?
Like, when you, at what age you felt that you are different?
Okay. So,
and how your parents or how your loved ones perceived that?
Okay. I realized I wasn't particularly cisgender when I was in my final year of school or the first year of college, around that time. So I was just graduating from higher secondary and was going into college. Around that time, I realized that I wasn't probably a cisgender woman. And later, about a year later, when I was in my second year of BSc, I realized that I am a transgender man. After exploring my identity and so on, and this exploration basically came through by a lot of research on the internet, basically, and just talking to a lot of other trans people. That's basically what I did. I talked to other trans people. I read about stuff on the internet. And one of the things that helped me the most was that during that time when I was a fresher in college, my boyfriend was also a transgender. Sorry if the camera is a bit shaky. So he's the person who basically helped me realize that I wasn't cisgender, which eventually led me to realize that I am a transgender man. Now, this realization wasn't easy at first, and it took time to come to terms with it. And as a millennial, one of the first things I did when I realized that I'm a transgender, I made a YouTube video about it. So that's how I came out to a lot of people in my IRL circles. I told them in person before that. And for a lot of people who knew me in person, the YouTube video was the first thing they saw to know that I'm transgender. But this isn't how I came out to my family. My family didn't know. It was after I graduated my bachelor's and I was in my first year of master's, which is like a couple of years back, when I came out to my family. And my family aren't that supportive of me about it. They still think that it's a phase. My dad is supportive, but the rest of my family, they aren't. So yeah.
And how people perceive you as your identity, like your friends or any new people that you meet?
Okay, so people who know me, they know me as a transgender man. They refer to me by masculine pronouns and adjectives and such. But whenever I meet a stranger, or even the people at the bus, at the metro and so on, they refer to me as a woman. They see me as a woman. They think that my presentation is that of a feminine nature, and they refer to me as a woman. Mani, ami odi pashe uthi. Can I speak in Bengali?
No, it's okay if you keep it in English.
Okay, so it will be a bit difficult to translate in English. So when I go up in a bus, the people will say, "Okay, ma'am, please take your seat." So they will go, "Ma'am." In Bengali, they'll say, "Didi boshun ekhane." So, "Ma'am, please take your seat," and so on. So, that's what I face in the in public transport and other places.
So do you think that these kinds of languages, the gender should not be there, right? Like people should use like, please take the seat, or like in other ways.
To an extent, I feel yeah, because you don't really, you can't really know what gender a person is. Like yeah, if there are 100 people, there will be a 98% of the people will be cisgender. Like out of 100 people, 98 people will be cisgender. But there are still two people who are transgender or non-binary and so on. So you can't assume by the basis of someone's appearance the what their gender is. It might be true for majority of people, but it isn't true for all people. So to be on the safe side, I will say that a gender neutral addressing of a stranger is the best thing, because that's what I try to do basically. Because like when I meet up a person, I'll say please, like in Bengali I'll say apni. I won't say sir or ma'am or didi or dada or something like that. I'll just say apni. I'll give them the respect by saying apni, but nothing gender. And it's same thing in English, like please sit here. And even like, you know, when we are speaking to a group of people, a lot of people will say ladies and gentlemen. We know that that's not inclusive at all, so instead we'll say everyone or everyone present here or stuff like that. So yeah, I sure do think that an inclusive language or gender neutral language will be much more helpful in day-to-day basis, not just for me but for everyone basically.
Particular experience that you'd like to share with us, if it is okay with you?
Will you mind if it's a negative experience? If it's a negative experience?
Yeah. Completely fine.
Okay. It's, I think, at least a couple of years now. So I went to this movie screening with some of my friends. So this was at a multiplex. So none of them had turned up, and I really needed to go to the bathroom. So I went to the men's restroom. I saw that no one was using it, so I'll be fine using it if I'm alone, since no one else is around. So I went there, and I, in the men's restroom, there are real urinals and stalls. So I just straight up went into a stall and used it. Now, when I came out of the stall, there were security guards. And there were security guards, and I didn't pay any heed to them. So I was washing my hands, and they're like, ma'am, why are you here? And I'm like, I just used the restroom, and I'm just, they're like, ma'am, you are in the long list. Just reinforcing the word ma'am. And I'm like, I just used it now, I'm just washing my hands, please let me go. And they're like, no ma'am, this is the wrong place. And they're like, I'm leaving. I'm like, I'm leaving. I have used it and I'm leaving. And they're like, no ma'am. They were the cleaning staff. And they're like, we will call the security. Please don't leave. And they called the security, and they're like, look at this ma'am who is using the men's restroom. And security were like, please use the ladies' room for the next time. I'm like, I have done my job. Please let me leave. Like, please let me leave the room. And I was kind of scared, because they were all cisgender men, and being a cisgender man in a restroom space is pretty damn terrifying, even especially if they are threatening you. And I was like pretty scared, and like, and I just packed up my bag and left. It was a huge relief when I just saw my friends who were waiting outside. They had arrived, and I immediately told them what happened, and they were like, just stay with us, you'll be fine. For the rest of the day, I was like under constant vigilance of the mall security guards. They were like telling each other about what I did. Like, they were whispering about each other whenever they saw me. And I pretty, pretty damn uncomfortable. Sorry. Sorry.
What does the connotation transgender mean to you? Like, are you okay with it being an umbrella term?
Yeah, I'm fine with it. Like, when you're saying the phrase umbrella term to mean the word transgender, you mean that non-binary people are using it, trans men are using it, trans women are using it, a lot of people who don't feel like they're cisgender are using it. That's what you mean, right? and people who are at different phases of their transitioning are using it. I'm perfectly fine with it because, how can I say this in the best way? Like, we are all not cisgender, right? Even a binary trans woman, a trans man like myself, or a non-binary person, we are all unified under the label of being not cisgender. We are not cisgender. We do not align with the gender that was assigned to us at birth. So we are not cisgenders, and the phrase transgender perfectly describes that. Now, we might be at different stages of our transition. Some people have transitioned long ago. Some people are still transitioning. I'm still someone who hasn't started his transitioning yet. So we are all at different phases. So it's perfectly fine to use the word transgender as a term because it isn't harming anyone, to be honest.
Do you want to give a message to our readers of the magazine?
I don't really have like any deep or profound message. Just that I'll say some phrases which are like widespread in the online trans communities. Like whenever you go to a trans communities, we'll always say trans rights are human rights, trans women, men are men, trans women are women, which may seem like obvious at first, but on the internet and even in real life, we see that trans people are not treated as the gender that we are. We are constantly misgendered, harassed, our rights are constantly being denied and so on. So even though this just sound like just bland platitudes, the phrases trans rights are human rights, trans men are men, trans women are women, non-binary people are non-binary, they mean so much more. So that's what I just pass on to you.
Thank you. It was nice talking to you.
Okay.